So to me, this is uptrend, right? To me, this is uptrend because you see Senkou Span B to be flat, but I see Senkou Span A is moving up and Kijun Sen is moving up too. So to me, this is still uptrend, and I will still expect the price to be breaking this recent high, even upwards in a 4-hour chart. This is still on my watch list, right? USDJPY 4-hour chart, I think this is still uptrend to me. And yeah, if I look at it more precisely, right, on this 4-hour chart, however, right, I can also draw a trend line like this way. And as long as the price moves along with the trend line, this is still uptrend, right? It's still uptrend. This is one of the confirmations that I can take. Probably I can draw the trend line from here. And as long as the price keeps going upwards, as long as the price does not break this trend line downwards, then this is still uptrend. And also, I can take the Fibonacci retracement from this recent low to the recent high, right? This was, yeah, between 23.6 and 38.2% retracement level from these places. So yeah, there might be chance still that the price might be going downwards down to 23.6 points, and but still we can still expect the price to be keep going upwards this way, because I can see Kumo still up. It's got thickness to it, and also Kijun Sen is moving up too. But as soon as I see Kijun Sen to become flat, or Senkou Span A to start retracing like this way, then I will stop thinking about buying it. Doing this from my old PC here, but yeah, anyways. So if daily chart is horizontal, right? So let's say in this chart, right, in this checklist, oftentimes you see daily chart might be horizontal, right? Daily chart might be horizontal. In that case, 4-hour chart can be uptrend, or it can be going down, or it can be in range too. And when daily chart is moving up, in a 4-hour chart, you might see it might also moving up, or it might also moving horizontal, but you never see it going down, right? And when daily chart is moving down, you might see in 4-hour chart it's horizontal, or it might be going down, but you don't see it's going up. These are the main three patterns by looking at the daily or 4-hour chart. And if you see daily chart moving up and 4-hour chart moving down, right, you have to change your strategy. Because I think you're capturing just too small like period, right? Too small parameters in any indicators. You have to go like a bigger setup on your indicators. So in my analysis, right, when daily chart is horizontal, I can see 4-hour chart moving up, down, or horizontal too. And I take these. Right, I take this and I go down to middle time frame for confirmations. Right, I take either 1 hour or 30 minute time frame and further confirm this up or downtrend. Or when the daily chart is moving up, then I take this daily chart and move down to middle time frame to confirm further. Right, or when I see it's moving down, I go down to middle time frame to look for the downtrend confirmation further. And when I see, right, so when I see, let's say, when I see the daily chart is moving up, and also 4-hour chart is moving up too, in this case, I compare in this daily chart uptrend and also 4-hour chart uptrend, and see which one of these time frame uptrend is more stronger. And if I find daily chart uptrend is more stronger, then I will take this daily chart and move down to middle time frame for further confirmation. Or when I see 4-hour chart uptrend is more stronger than daily, let's say in 4-hour chart the Kumo is more steadily moving up, it's got more thickness in Kumo, and Senkou Span B, A are also moving up while daily Kumo is like horizontal in Kumo, then I'll take 4-hour chart as a stronger bullish trend, and I go down to middle time frame for confirmations, things like that, right? When daily is moving down, and yeah, when I look at the 4-hour chart to me moving down, it's the same thing. It's the same thing. I never see daily moving up and 4-hour chart moving down, or daily moving down and 4-hour chart moving up. I don't see that. Before ending this video, let me introduce a word from Goichi Hosoda, the original creator of Ichimoku Kinkouhyo, that I think is profound. He says, always take trades as if you have no positions. When you just watch the market and analyze the chart, you can create scenarios for buy and sell and objective to the market. But as soon as you have a position, you become subjective towards the direction of your position. When you have a buy, then you expect the market to go up and you start to analyze the chart that way. Or when you have a sell, you start to look for the reasons for the market to go down. But Goichi Hosoda says that's not how traders should be. He says always trade as if you have no positions. So don't be subjective, be objective to the market, especially while taking trades. If you liked today's video, please press the good button and please subscribe and hit the bell so that you get notified as I do the next live or upload a new video. I wish you a trade success and see you on the next live or video. Stay gold!